Carroll on behalf of Bernina World of Sewing in Raleigh and Wilmington, North Carolina, and welcome to month 4 of the City of Oaks Quilt Along. This month we're going to be doing the Inside the Beltline block, also known as the Split Rex block. You might think, well, what does Inside the Beltline mean? And I had that same question when I moved here 22 years ago. Inside the Beltline is simply a way to denote whether you are living in the older part of Raleigh or the newer part of Raleigh. The older part of Raleigh, being inside the Beltline, is closer to downtown, and the homes tend to be older and on smaller lots. Once you go outside the Beltline, the homes become progressively newer in all directions. And when you get outside the other Beltline, like outside of 540 where I live, you can really see that the houses are on bigger lots, and you know, urban sprawl has taken over Raleigh. So when you hear the term inside the Beltline, that's what that means, that you live in the older part of Raleigh versus the newer part of Raleigh, which is outside of 540 and outside of even 540. So anyway, that's kind of how that works. This month we're going to be doing the using the Deb Tucker Split Rex ruler, and we're going to be using that to make our blocks. I'm going to hold my Split Rex ruler up for you to see, and I've got my little sandpaper dots on the back of it here, leftovers from my sandpaper dots on the back of it here to keep it from moving when I'm doing all my trimming. But this is the Deb Tucker Split Rex ruler. This is what it looks like. Also this month we're going to be using our Blade Saver thread cutter, because we're going to be doing some chain piecing again, and chain piecing is fun if you remember. We're going to need our strip stick ironing tool. We're going to need our portable design board. Surprise, surprise. This is like our best friend. I have two of them. I keep them right next to my sewing machine. They are so handy to have. And we're also going to need our turning cutting mat, because we have a lot of trimming to do. And if you have one of these, believe me, it makes your life a lot easier. So go ahead and do your cutting like it says in the instructions, in the printed instructions, and meet me back here in a minute and we'll start constructing these blocks. Okay, here we go. Here we're taking a look at the Split Rex ruler that we're going to be using to make these blocks. It looks complicated with all these lines, but don't worry. Once we finish these, you're going to be the expert. There are two types of blocks that make up these Split Rex units, type 1 and type 2. First, we're going to make the type 1 blocks. Take one strip of your background fabric and one strip of your focus fabric and lay them right side up. Remove the selvages. Line up your Split Rex ruler as shown in the picture and make your first cut. Next, turn your Split Rex ruler 180 degrees and get ready to make your second cut. Line up the bottom edge of your fabric as shown on that second trim line, and line the angled part of your fabric on the line as shown. This will allow you to make your second cut. And when you make these cuts, keep your triangles paired together. Do not separate your triangles. Now you can see we've made our first two cuts. Keep rotating your ruler back and forth until you've cut the required number of pieces according to the instructions. Now we're going to make our type 2 blocks. Pair up a piece of your background fabric with a piece of your focus fabric, wrong sides up. Trim off your selvages. We're going to line up our Split Rex ruler just like we did before. Rotate your Split Rex ruler 180 degrees and line up the bottom edge of your fabric along that tiny little second cut line at the bottom and make your second cut. Keep rotating your ruler back and forth until you've made the required number of cuts. And once again, leave your triangles paired together. Now it's time to go to the sewing machine. And this block also lends itself to some very great chain piecing. Keep those triangles paired together as you cut them. Match up your triangles with the wide end of one matching up with the narrow end of the other with a tiny little bit hanging over the edge on either side. You can see here just a little bit hanging off. You can see just a little bit hanging over, and we're gonna stitch this in a 1/4 inch seam allowance with your stitch length shortened. Shorten that stitch length to 2.0 or less because we are gonna be trimming these blocks. When you're making the blocks, for each focus fabric, you need to press the seam a different direction so they will nest. So for the type 1 blocks, press your seams toward the focus fabric, and for the type 2 blocks, press the seams toward the background fabric, and this will allow your seams to nest. Now we're going to trim. Lay your split rex ruler on top of your block, and this is where your turning cutting mat will come in handy, and line up that diagonal and make the cut, trimming two sides. And we're trimming this down to 3.5 by 6.5. You can see what a completely trimmed block looks like. This is about the amount you should be trimming off. If you're trimming off more than that, you're in trouble. Regroup. The turning cutting mat allows you to trim more than one at a time, and this is a big time saver. Trim two sides and turn. Now it's time to start sewing our blocks together. And this is what a completed block will look like. These are the components that go into a completed block. So it's kind of like a diamond and 2 half diamonds. Since we've pressed our seams the correct way, opposite for each fabric, our seams should nest up just fine. I've got my blocks laid out on the ironing board. And when I'm sewing these together, to make sure that those points line up, I always start in the center and sew from the center out. I've pressed my joining seams open, and I will pin from the center and sew from the center out. I'm using my strip stick to press my seams open after I've sewn them together. And this is what the finished block looks like. So you'll be making 6 of these blocks for your quilt. I highly suggest paying attention to how you press those seams, and also start at the center and stitch out to maximize your chances of having everything line up. And this is what the finished row looks like. You may want to sew yours into a row, you may not. It's up to you to decide how to do it. So that takes care of the inside the belt line block for this month. Thank you so much for joining us, and I'm just so happy that you've joined us on this journey. Next month, we're going to be doing the 5 points block, which is a Lemoine star block. We'll be making 6 of those, and we'll be using our Deb Tucker Lemoine star ruler. So thanks so much for viewing the video, and please contact me at any time if you have any issues or questions about these blocks. My email is amy27614@gmail.com. And once again, I'm Amy O'Donnell on behalf of Bernina World of Sewing in Raleigh and Wilmington. And thank you for tuning in for this month's Quilt Along video. Have a great month and happy sewing, everybody.
There's been so many things that's held us down, but now